Good morning. In the last lecture, I discuss about the basics of the digital communication system. Basics of means basically the frequency spectrum, block diagram of the digital communication system, last lectures we discussed about the different frequency ranges used for the communication system, including the block diagram of the digital transmitter, block diagram of the digital receivers and channel. Last lecture, now I discussed this is the general block diagram of the digital communication system. So any communication system includes, there are three main blocks. One is the transmitter, channel and receiver. In digital communication system also, basically the source of information, now it generates the information. Information may be any kind, maybe text form, maybe audio form, maybe video form. So any kind of signal can be generated by the source of information. Now this generated information by processed by some signal processing unit, and this processed data is transmitted by the transmitter. Okay? Basically the transmitter is an electronic device which is doing some kind of the signal processing, and they transmit the processed data by the channel. So what is the channel? Channel is a way, channel is a path which connects the transmitter to the receiver, and the receiver is also a block or the electronic devices which also doing some kind of signal processing, and it separate out the information signal from the composite signal or the received signal. Finally, last topic is the information sink, which give the information to the destination point. So this is the block diagram of the first block information sources, and then this is the block diagram of the digital transmitter which I discussed in the previous classes. This is the channel may be two kind, either the wireless channel or the wired channel. Wireless channel means if transmitter is connected with the receiver by the without any physical media. Without any physical media means it is connected by the free space. Wired media means the transmitter is connected by some kind of physical media with the receiver. So this is two types of channel. Then in last lecture also discussed the basic diagram of the digital receiver. Here the digital receiver basically doing the reverse process of the transmitter. Also discuss the advantages and disadvantages of the digital communication system. Today I will discuss about the characterization of the digital communication. Characterization of the digital communication are information theoretic approach to define the digital communication system. Here include some blocks. The first block is discrete sources which are used to generate the discrete signal. Discrete random signal means it generates the signal which are in the random nature. Random nature means basically discrete time, discrete amplitude signal. Discrete time, discrete amplitude means suppose this is the time t1, this is the time t2, this is the time t3, t4. For example, suppose this is 1.5 volt, this is the 1 volt, this is the 1.25 volt, this is the 2 volt. Discrete time means signal is defined only the discrete time, not the continuous time. At t1 time, now amplitude signal is defined by the 1.5 volt. At t2 time, it is 1 volt. At t3 time, it is 1.25 volt. And t4 time, it is the 2 volt. Means signal is defined at the discrete time of events. Right? Now signal is continuously defined. Signal is not defined at every time of instances. Only defined in the discrete time of. So it generate discrete forces generate the discrete time, discrete amplitude signals. Clear? And next block is the source encoder. So the basic funda of the source encoder is try to represent the source data. Source signal at the lower rate. Lower rate means if you compare the bit rate of the source coder output denoted by RBD S, RBD S is always less than the RBD, RBD is the bit rate. How to define bit rate? Bit rate is defined by how many of bits is transmitted in the per second. Clear? For example, suppose we have the 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 0, 0, 1. There are 6 bits. The bit rate is 6 BPS. 6 bits per second. Now 6 bits are transmitted in the per second. Clear? This is the bit rate. Finally, channel encoder. Channel encoder. And here the source encoder represent the source data at the lower rate by doing some signal processing, or it convert the source data into the variable length of the coding. Variable length of the coding. For example, suppose it generate the x1, x2 up to xj. Here, suppose x1 is denoted by 010, x2 is 0010. Up to xj is the 1101. So every symbol is defined by the different codes or variable. Here the 4 bit, 3 bits, 4 bit, here the 6 bit data. So every symbol, basically this is the next block is the channel encoder. Channel encoder is the advanced signal processing block. Now it represents the signal to the next block according to the channel, according to the properties, features and limitations of the channel, right? The channel encoding represents the fixed length coding while source encoding represents the variable length coding. Now next block is the basically channel decoder. The reverse process of the channel encoder is the channel decoder, while the reverse process of the source encoder is the channel source decoder. Finally, you got the information at the information center. Here, so I will discuss in detail. The characterization of digital communication is defined, is described in detail by the block diagram. Clear? So before going into the depth of the characterization of digital communication system, I would like to know some basic definitions which are basically very essential to describing the characterization of digital communication system. The first definition, the probability. What do you mean by probability? Yeah? Probability is defined the number of favorable event to the total number of event. Mathematically, basically, P is the summation of x belong to A, P, X, S. Next is the random experiment. Random experiment basically is an experiment whose outcome has to be among a set of events that are completely known but whose outcome is unknown. For example, if you are throwing a dice, you don't know what outcome will come. It may be either 1, it may be either 2, it may be the either 6, but you don't know the what exactly outcome will come. Yeah? Similarly, tossing a fair point basically this is the random experiment, but whose outcome is uncertain. It may be come the head or it may come to the tail. Next, the statistical model. Now this random experiment is set of k possibilities known as the statistical model. Now the sample space is denoted by the capital S, which is equal to, for example, if throwing the disc, there are 6 outcome may come, either 1, 2, up to 6. So all possible outcome 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. This is known as the sample space. For example, tossing a coin, fair coin, there are two possible outcomes, either head or tail. This is head or tail. These are known as the sample space. Here, tail event. How to define the event? Event basically, this is the subset of sample space. Event to define the subset of sample space. Now, in symbol, what do you mean by in symbol? Suppose you have any random variable x. Which denote the alphabets, x1, x2, up to xz are the data. X are the letters, and now these set of the letters is known as alphabets. If these letters occur with the probability, suppose px1, this occur with the probability px2, this with the probability pxj. Now these combination, the alphabet coming with their probabilities is known as ensemble. Yeah, individual x1, x2, x is known as letter. Now set of these x1, 2x is known as alphabet. Yeah, if alphabet is given corresponding to their probability of occurrence, now these combination is known as ensemble. Yeah, then joint probabilistic model or joint statistical model. Suppose we have two random experiment. This is the x, this is the y. It gives some outcome. This is also give some outcome. If the input of this random experiment, suppose this is the experiment first, this is the experiment second. If this is the outcome of experiment first, which is input of the experiment second. Clear? And finally, this is the outcome of experiment second. If you want to calculate what is the joint outcome of these two random experiments, this is denoted by the matrix x1, y1, where x emit the data x1, x2, up to xj, where y is y1, y2, up to yk. So this pxy probability, a joint probability corresponding to random variable x and random variable y, is denoted by x1, y1, x1, y2, x1, yk. Similarly, x2, y1, x2, y2, x2, yk. Similarly, xj, y1, xj, y2, xj, yk. Yeah? By this way, now we can find the probability of the joint experiment, joint random variable x and random variable y. Now next, random variable. How to define random variable? Basically, a random variable is an event. Random variable event is an experiment whose outcome are mapped to a real number. Yeah. So these are next the probabilities. Conditional probability. How to define conditional probability? Suppose we have to conclude P A given B. P A given B means we have to calculate probability corresponding to event A while event B is given. Clear? Mathematically, it is P AB upon PB. P AB upon PB means this is the joint probability, ratio of the joint probability to the probability corresponding to given event B. In communication term, we have to calculate the probability corresponding to event A while event B is given. For example, suppose this is the A is the transmitter, B is the receiver, and C is the channel. This is the transmitter, this is the receiver, and this is the channel. Yeah? What do you mean by this P A given B? P A given B means we have to calculate the probability corresponding to receiver, receive data while P is given means Y signal is received at the receiver side. Here signal has received at the receiver side. We have to know what the information was transmitted to the transmitter side. So this is defined by the conditional probability. Similarly, P given A, this is equal to P, where P A non-zero. Here, now this quantity is equal to non-zero. This is, we have to calculate the probability of occurrence of the received signal at the receiver while A is transmitted at the transmitter side. So this is defined by the conditional probability. So relationship of the conditional probability with the joint probabilities is known as Bayes theorem. Right? Now you can see here, for the Bayes theorem, now the probability corresponding to random variable X is the non-negative quantity, also corresponding to Y is the non-negative quantity. Now Px given Y is, now this, we know that, what is the relationship? Relationship of the PAB, you can see from here, now PA given, AB means joint probability equals to PA given B into PB, or this is equals to PB given A into PA. So this formula is known as Bayes theorem. This formula is known as Bayes theorem. So Bayes theorem tells about the relationship between joint probability with the conditional probability. Or this is the relationship among the joint probability, conditional probability and the marginal probabilities. The next slide. Now, I already told the probability schemes. There are following five probability scheme of the interest in the product space of the random variable X and Y. So I already told you now, for example, if I describe these probabilities in terms of the communication system. Communication system means, suppose this is the transmitter, this is channel, and this is receiver. Suppose transmitter is defined by the random variable X, receiver is denoted by the random variable Y. Yeah? Then how to characterize the channel? Because at the channel, now you can transmit the signal, and also by here you can receive the signal. So this is denoted by joint probability, R X given Y, R Y given X. So this is channel characterized by other joint probabilities R between two random variable X and Y, conditional probabilities between two random variable X and Y, R Y given X. Similarly, the first point P X Y is defining the joint probability. Joint probability means this. How to calculate the probability of the channel, joint information, this is the PXY. Similarly, from transmitter, this is PX, for receiver, this is PY. You can see here, PX is the marginal probabilities. Similarly, PY is the marginal probability matrix of random variable Y, and Px given Y is the conditional probability matrix of X given Y. X given Y means basically this is Y is given. Y is given if you are talking in terms of the communication system. Communication system means Y has received. Y, what signal has received? You want to know what was the information is transmitted by the transmitter. So this is defined by the Px given by means we have to calculate probability of occurrence of information corresponding to random variable X y information corresponding to random variable y has received. Similarly, p y given x means we have to calculate the information corresponding to random variable y while information corresponding to random variable x was transmitted. So this is defined by the probabilities. Then how to define the information in terms of information theory? How to characterize the information which are used in the digital communication system? Right? There are so many definitions of the information, but in terms of the information theory, the scientists define the information some other ways. The first definition by the scientist Hartley definition, it is based on two assumptions. It is based on two assumptions. The assumption first, all symbols which build up a message are independent. Independent means, suppose this is the information source denoted by random variable x, which generate the information. Information means discrete time, discrete amplitude, DTTA signal, which are x1, x2, up to xz. So assumption first tells all symbols which build up a message are independent, means x1 is independent of x2, x2 is independent of anyone x1, x3, up to xz, means all symbols are independent to each other. Here, no any symbol is depend to any other symbol. The assumption second, each symbol which build up a message can take any value from n possibility, but all possibilities are equally probable. For example, suppose x1 is occurrence of x1 by the probability p1, occurrence of x2 by the probability p2, occurrence of xz is by the probability pz. According to assumption second, now this p1 equals to p2 equals to pz means all symbols occur with the equal probabilities. Clear? Equal probability. This is the definition of information according to scientist Hartley. Now second definition by the Shannon. Shannon defines the information in some other ways. Means Shannon goes beyond the Nyquist and Hartley definition. Again Shannon choose two assumptions. Assumptions first, symbols occur independently, means Shannon also tells the first assumption of the Hartley is same, means all symbols are independent to each other, but Shannon tells the all symbols cannot be generated, cannot occur with the same probabilities, cannot be occurred with the same probability, means according to Shannon, now p1 should not be equal to p2, should not be equal to p3, should not be equal to pz. Means all symbols are independent to each other, but probability of occurrence of any symbols could not be same to probability of occurrence of any other symbols. Clear? So this is the definition. This definition is being popular in the information theory and coding. So according to Shannon information, suppose probability of occurrence, if probability of occurrence of any event is very high. Very high means, suppose 1. Minimum probability is 0. Maximum probability is 1. So according to scientist Shannon, if probability of occurrence of any event is high, now if information content is, suppose I define the information content is 0. According to scientist Shannon defined, if the probability of occurrence of any event is very high, that is 1, now its information content is very low. In other way, vice versa, if probability of occurrence of any event is very low, that is 0, now its information content is very high. Yeah? Scientist Shannon formulated the formula for the information based on these assumptions. The probability of occurrence is very high, its information content is very low. the probability of occurrence of any event is very low, if the information content is very high. Clear? For example, suppose this is equal to xj, where let xj is the random generation of the symbols x1, x2, xj, where j varying from 1 to xk, put here xk, xi, xi where I is 1 to j. Clear? Clear? Suppose if pxj is very high, means now information content of xj is very low. So substituting now these assumptions to define the information. So scientists Shannon defined xj, xj basically this is, now x is the random variable x, which is equals to log of 1 by p of xj. P of xj, now you can see here, if pxj is high, if pxj is high, now this is log of 1 by 1, 1, log 1 is 0, its information content is 0. Similarly, if you put now the probability of occurrence of j is low, now its information content 1 by 0 is infinite, log infinite is also infinite. So this is the formula which defines the information in terms of information theory and coding. This is the formula which defines the information. Clear? Now what is the unit of the information? Depending upon the base of this logarithm, now if base is 2, now unit is bits. If base 2, now unit of this information is bits. If here base e, if base e, now the unit is nats. If base e, the information unit is nats. If you are base 10, the unit is either deci or hartley. The unit of the information is basically based on the base of the logarithm. Then you can see next slide the unit. You can see here, the next slide, basically what is the unit of the information. I already told you, the unit of the information is basically the base on the base of the logarithm. If base is 2 of the logarithm, now unit is defined by the base, width. If base e, now unit is the nats. If base of logarithm is 10, now unit is deci or rk. Yeah? The properties of the information. Properties of the information means, if the probability of occurrence of any event is very high, now its information content is low. Information content is zero. For example, now in your daily routine, you listen, the sun is rises from the east. Yeah, everyone know sun is rises from the east, but if someone told you now today's sun is rising from the west, yeah, now this is, you know, this event is rarely happen, maybe not possible to happen. Now you suddenly ask what? Sun is rises from the east. Yeah, its information means probability of occurrence of this event is very very low, maybe zero, but it contains the lot of information. Right? So you can prove. Proof is easy. Now put Px j equals to 1. When put in this formula, I x of xj 1 by Px is 1. Now this is equals to 0. Information content is 0. Similarly, second property of the information is, if probability of occurrence, if Pxj is in between 0 to 1, substitute Pxj equals to 0, you will get the infinite information. If you put the Pxj equals to 1, you will get the zero information means you between zero to infinite. You got the information from zero to infinite. Means this is the non-negative. Non-negative quantity means I x is always greater than I equals to 0 means always positive quantity in between, and the probability of occurrence between 0 to 1, low to high, you will get the positive information. Right? Similarly, the property is third means if the probability, if we have the two events xj and xk, xj and xk are two events, and pxj and pxk are probability of occurrence of these two events. If pxj is greater than pxk, now the rich information contained is ixk is less than the ixj is less than the ixk. Clear? So this proof is also very easy. Next slide, now we can see next property is basically I x y x y k is sum of these two individual information if these two random experiments are statistically independent means you can see here for this how to define xy xj by k from the formula. Now it is 1 by log pxj yk. Now we know that joint probability, we can write pab equals to pa plus pb if event A and B are statistically independent. If event A and B are statistically independent, now joint probability can be written as the probability corresponding to A, event A plus probability corresponding to event B. Similarly, put this condition here. So we can write here 1 upon log pxj plus, because log a to b equals to log a plus log b, log pyk. Clear? Pyk when xj and yk are independent are statistically independent. We can put here, this is 1 by log p xj plus 1 by log p yk, where this is equals to I of xj plus I of yk. So this proof is also very easy. When two events are statistically independent, the joint information corresponding to two events is equals to sum of the joint information corresponding to individual events. Clear? So these are the properties of information. Next slide, now we can see. Next slide, we can see entropy. Entropy, how to define the entropy? Entropy is basically the uncertainty or the average uncertainty, right? Mathematically, we can prove HX basically the entropy corresponding to transmitter in terms of communication. This is the transmitter. HY entropy corresponding to receiver. HXY, HX given Y, HY given X, the entropy, joint entropy, conditional entropy corresponding to channel, communication channel. Right? How to define the entropy? Entropy means this is the average information. Averaging of information is known as entropy. Mathematically, this is of averaging of information is known as entropy, or mean value of the information is known as entropy, or I define the ensemble of In simple, our information is known as entropy. Then, for example, suppose we have two random experiments. This is the random experiment first, denoted by random variable x. Suppose this is the random experiment second, denoted by y. If outcome of this random experiment first depends the input of the random experiment second. What is the joint information? Now you can see here, this is the y. Yeah. So hx basically the average information corresponding to random variable x. Hy average information corresponding to random variable y. Hxy average information. Yes, now you can see from here. Hx given y, basically the union of two random variables. Now this is the average information corresponding to two random variables x and y. Clear? And Hx given y basically this is average information corresponding to this. Hy given x, average information corresponding to this. And this portion basically define the Ixy, virtual average information. Virtual average information which are present at the transmitter as well as receiver side. Clear? This is the graphical representation of different entropies and mutual information. There are following interpretation of the five entropies corresponding to mentioned five probability schemes. So Hxy, basically this is the average information per pair of the transmitted and received character. This tells about the entropy of the whole system. Entropy of the whole system is consisting of the transmitter, channel as well as receiver. Second, Hx. Hx is average information per character of the source. Per character of the source means it tells about the average information corresponding to only transmitter. Here, this is also known as marginal entropy. Similarly, Hy. It tells about the average information per character at the destination, means at the receiver. This is also known as the marginal entropy corresponding to random variable y. Next is the Hy given x. Hy given x means what? What is the average information of the received signal while x is transmitted, while y information is transmitted, given. So we define the specific character xk being transmitted and one of the permissible yz may be received. May be received means we have to calculate the average information corresponding to random variable y while random variable x is transmitted, is given. Clear? Similarly, hx given y means we have to calculate the average information of the random variable x, means average information of the transmitted signal y signal y signal y means random variable y is given. Mathematically, what is the mathematical relationship of the these entropies? So now you can see here, we know that now averaging of the self information, if information consists of the single random variable, now it is known as the self information. I self information. So averaging of self information known as entropy. Or principle of the self information is known as sorry. averaging mean symbol of the cell information is known as entropy. Mathematically, how to prove this is sum of for j equals to 1 to n p of xj into log into log of 1 by p of xj into log of p of xj. Here r we can put here. Now we know that log a upon b equals to log a minus log b. If you are putting log minus 0 minus this quantity, put here minus our summation j equals to 1 to m p of xj into log 1 minus log p of xj, where we know that log 1 is 0. Now this is equals to summation j equals to 1 to m pxj into minus log of pxj. Put minus outside, j equals to 1 to m pxj into log of pxj. So this is equals to hx. Clear? Similarly, you can put for hy equals to minus push k equals to 1 to n p of yk into log of p of yk. So this is the average information at the transmitter side, average information at the receiver side, receive signal by hxy. The total information corresponding to whole communication system or joint information, joint average information. So this is equals to summation j equals to 1 to m. This is the information corresponding to transmitter. K equals to 1 to n. Sum of the information at the receiver side. PXJYK joint probability into log of 1 upon PXJYK. Again we can put 1 by x is the minus log, so this is equals to minus summation j equals to 1 to m summation k equals to 1 to n PXJYK into log of PXJYK. So this is the mathematical relationship of the joint entropy or joint average information of the whole communication system. Similarly, you can see here HXY, HX given Y or HY given X. So HX given Y, this is equals to summation minus J equals to 1 to M k equals to 1 to n pxjyk into log of pxj given yk. Now we know that joint probability, we know that conditional probability PA given B equals to PAB upon PB. Now we know that the relationship among inter-home communication system, we can put here the PXJYK PAB equals to this multiply by this, means PXJYK equals to P X J given Y K up to P of Y K. Substitute this value, now this probability here, you will get minus j equals to 1 to m, k equals to 1 to n. Now this quantity is p xj given yk into p yk log p xj given yk. So this is the mathematical relationship of x given y. Similarly, you can put hy given x by the formula. So this is the mathematical relationship which are used to find the numerical value of the average information of the transmitter and average information of the receiver and the average information of the whole communication system or average information of the received data while signal was transmitted or average information of the transmitter data while signal was received at the receiver side. So these are the different types of the mathematical relationship of the entropies. In next slide, I am going to discuss about the entropy meanings. Basically, Hx and Hy give the indication of the probabilistic nature of the transmitter and receiver respectively. Basically, this is Hx and Hy is also known as marginal entropies. Clear? And Hxy is the joint entropy while Hx given y or y given x is known as conditional entropy. What is the basically interpretation of these Hx given y, Hy given x in terms of the communication system? Basically, Hx give the average information or indication of the probabilistic nature of the transmitter, Hy is the indication of the probabilistic nature of the receiver, Hxy is the probabilistic nature of the whole communication system, Hx given y is the probabilistic nature of the transmitted signal while y is received, and Hy given x is the probabilistic nature of the received signal by x was transmitted. So these the meanings of the entropies. The same thing, now you can see here Hxy give the probabilistic nature of the communication signal channel as whole, or basically the union of random variable x and y. It gives the Hy given x the indication of the noise in the presence of noise, presence of interference, what signal is received at the receiver. Here Hx given y give the measure of equivocation, how well one can recover the input content from the output. So these are the meanings of the information. Similarly, next is the properties of the entropies. Properties of the entropies means this is the first. Now we know that Hx equals to summation j equals to 1 to m p of xj into log p of xj. So information, average information content is 0 if all possibilities are 0 except 1, for it must be unity. For example, suppose this is the xj equals to x1, x2 up to xj. These are the symbols. Suppose the probability of occurrence of this symbol is 0. This is again 0. Suppose this is 1. Or similarly, probability of occurrence of this event is 1, all other are 0. Or this is 0, 1, all other are 0. Means the probability of occurrence of any event, only single event is 1, and all probabilities are 0. Now substitute this probability in this equation, you will get the average information of corresponding random variable is 0. This is the property first. Similarly, second property is Hx equals to log m base 2 if all possibilities are equiprobable. so that Px equals to P equals to 1 by m. For example, suppose this is the probability 5 symbols. Probability is 0.2 up to this is the x value. This is again 0.2. Means probability of occurrence of x1 is equals to probability of occurrence of x2 or equals to probability of occurrence of x5. There are 5 symbols. All probabilities are equal. Clear? All probabilities are equal means p1 equals to p2 equals to p3 p4 equals to p5 equals to p. Assume to be p. Clear? Then hx is, this is equals to, probability is how much? 1 by 5 time of the p. This is the second properties. Similarly, third properties tells if probability is varying, if this Pxj is varying, ranging from 0 to 1, if you substitute the basically probability is 0, if probability of occurrence of any event is 0, now its information content is infinite. And averaging of that information content is known as entropy. If information content is infinite, means average information is also very much, very high. If information content is very, probability of occurrence is very high, its information content is zero. Its average information is also zero. So also entropy is varying from zero to infinite, means non-negative quantity. For the probability of occurrence of event is varying from 0 to 1, now its information content either 0 or infinite, means no negative information. So it ranges 0 to infinite, means non-negative integer, non-negative average information. Okay. So these are the basically properties of the entropies, average information. Now the relationship of the different entropies, what is the relationship of the joint entropy with the marginal entropy, with the conditional entropies, basically this is defined by the chain rule. This is defined by the chain rule. So chain rule states that the chain rule allows us to relate the joint entropy to the conditional entropy via marginal entropy via hx or hy. Clear? So you can see basically hxy equals to hx given y plus hy or hy given x plus hx. Clear? So this is basically known as the chain rule. How to prove basically this chain rule? Hxy equals to hx given y plus hy. Prove now this. Okay, now we know that hxy equals to minus summation j equals to 1 to m, summation k equals to 1 to n, Pxjyk log of Pxjyk. This is the formulation of joint entropy, right? Now we know that basically this quantity. We know that now you can see from here xjyk equals to Pxj given yk into P yj. So we can put here Pxjyk equals to Pxj given yk into p of yk. Substitute this value here. So yeah, you can put here j equals to 1 to m, k equals to 1 to n, p of xj yk log of this quantity, p of xj given yk into p of yk. TF5. Right? Now we know that log A into B equals to log A plus log B. Now substituting here, so you can put here minus J equals to 1 to M, summation K equals to 1 to N, P of X J Y K log P of X J given Y K minus here minus and minus minus plus multiplies minus summation J equals to 1 to M K equals to 1 to N P of X J Y K into log of P of Y K. Yeah. Now we know that this is the formula of which term P. You can see from the previous slide. Now you can see here. This is the quantity. This quantity is. This is the formula of Hx given by. This is the minus of this quantity Hx given by and minus this quantity. Here the log of Px. Log of Pyk. Clear? If we change here the summation k equals to 1 to n summation j equals to 1 to m P of x j y k log P of y k. Now this quantity, if we have the joint probability, if we find the summation with respect to j, now you will get the information corresponding to random variable y. If we find the summation with respect to k, now you will get the information, I mean probability corresponding to x. So this is equals to P of y k. This is the probability corresponding to y k. Clear? So now I'm writing here. This is equals to h x given y minus summation k equals to 1 to n. This quantity is P of yk. P of yk into log of P of yk. Yeah? Now we know that from this relationship, minus some summation this P of yk into log of P yk hy. This is hx given by minus of this is plus h of. By this way you can prove the chain rule. Now second formula you can also prove. This is h y given x plus hx. Yeah? By substituting second formula, second probability means this formula. The joint probability is equal to either xz given by k into p by k, or put x probability yk given xj into bxj. If you are substituting this value, now you will prove the second formula, second relationship of the chain rule. Right? So this is the basically relationship of the different entropies. Now these are the properties of the conditional property. So there are different properties of the conditional entropies. Means h y given x is always non-negative quantities. Non-negative quantities, because we have proved that the average information, the range of the probability of occurrence from 0 to 1 is a non-negative quantity. Means here again the h y given x is always non-negative quantity. Similarly h x given y is also non-negative quantity, and you will always find conditional entropy is always less than or equal to marginal entropy corresponding to random variable y if and only if x and y are statistically independent. Similarly, in similar fashion, hx given y is always less than or equal to the marginal entropy corresponding to random variable x if x and y are statistically independent. Clear? If you are measuring the entropy, in joint entropy, yx or hxy both are same. Clear? So both are same. Both are same means if you are measuring the h, this is equal to j equals to 1 to m, k equals to 1 to n, pxjyk log of pxjyk or measuring hyx, but yx means this is k equals to 1 to n, j equals to 1 to n, pxjyk log of p x y k, you will get the same information in the both the data. Clear? Fine? So these are the properties of the conditional entropies. I will discuss about the mutual information. Yeah? The mutual information is basically defined the you will get the same information if you are assuming transmitter as a receiver and receiver as a transmitter. So in both the cases basically you will get the same information. So for example of the information this is used as a binary symmetric channel. In binary symmetric channel, if you consider transmitter as a receiver and receiver considered as a transmitter, in both the way you will get the same information. That information is known as mutual information. Clear? Mutual information, how to define the mutual information? Mutual information is basically defined. This is the mutual information equals to the initial uncertainty to the final uncertainty. Clear? So this is initial uncertainty minus final uncertainty. Initial information means you have to transmit the information corresponding to random variable x. Corresponding to transmitter. So this is equal to I of xa. Final information means you have received the signal means this is I of yk given xa. Clear? How to define this information? This information uncertainty is basically P of means this is the information, initial information means basically this is log of 1 by Pxa or we can put here minus log of Pxa. Similarly minus of P yk given Xa. Yk given xa means this is the log of. This is the final uncertainty means we have to calculate the probability of occurrence of yk while xa was transmitted. Signal is transmitted, we have to find the information corresponding to received signal. Here the initial signal. We can write here log a minus b equals to log a upon b. We can put here log minus minus plus and here minus 2. You can log p yk given xj minus log p of xj. This is equal to log p yk given xj upon p of xj. This is the IHZYK. This relationship is known as mutual information. The ratio of these two probabilities, more exactly, units logarithm determine the gain of information. Clear? So this information, this is also known as the posteriori information. And this is known as prior information. The ratio of the posterior to the prior information is known as gain of information, or this is also known as mutual information, right? Or in some other way, it is defined as the difference between initial uncertainty to the final uncertainty is defined the mutual information, right? So mutual information is also denoted by I small xj colon yk. Clear? The next topic is the average mutual information. Average mutual information. Average mutual information, it is denoted by capital I, capital X, colon, capital Y. Basically, it is the averaging of the mutual information is known as average mutual information. So this is equals to I small xj colon yk. This is equals to expectation of xj colon yk, known as the average mutual information. So this is equals to mathematically how to summation j equals to 1 to m. K equals to 1 to n, P of x, j, y, k into I, x, j, colon, y, k. Now we know that summation j equals to 1, k equals to 1, n, m, P, x, j, y, k into this quantity, this is equal to log of P yk given xj upon P of xj. So this is the mathematical formulation of the joint information, right? Mathematical relationship of this quantity. This is a mathematical relationship of the average mutual information. Actually, the average mutual information of all the pair of symbols IX colon Y shows the amount of information containing in average in one received message with respect to one transmitted message. Right? Now, average mutual information is also referred to as transinformation. Transinformation means information transmitted through the channel. Information transmitted through the channel. Right? So there are following relationship among the average mutual information with the different entropies. So these relationship is, see this, average mutual information equals to hx minus h x given by r hy minus h y given x, or this is equals to hx plus hx plus hy minus hxy. This is the relationship of the average mutual information with the different entropies, right? Different entropies, while we know that hx equals to समेशन जे इक्वल्स टू 1 टू एम पीएक्स से लॉग पीएक्स से एच वाई इक्वल्स टू समेशन के इक्वल्स टू 1 टू एम पी वाई के लॉग पी वाई के एंड एच एक्स वाई इज द माइनस समेशन जे इक्वल्स टू 1 टू एम के इक्वल्स टू 1 टू एम पी एक्स से वाई के लॉग पी एक्स से वाई के क्लियर। तो यू कैन प्रूव नाउ दिस फार्मूला दिस इक्वेशन बाय द सिमिलर फैशन व्हिच you are proved in the chain rule, right? So these are the relationship of the different entropies with the average mutual information, right? Average, now you can see here hx given by Susan, average loss of information for a transmitted message with respect to received one, and hxy given as Susan loss of information for a received message with respect to transmitted one. There are three relationships: hx minus h, x given by hy minus hy given as similarly hx, similarly hx plus hy minus hxy. There are three formula which are related with the entropies. So these are the properties of the average mutual information. So there are following properties. If you are calculating h x colon y, this is same identical to the I x colon y. So mutual information, basically this is I x colon y must be equal to I y colon x. The mutual information is symmetric in the argument. Yeah, I already you can see h I x colon y is always non-negative quantity. And this is the you can prove. These are the different properties of the mutual information. For time being, I'm not proving here, but the proof is very simple. Proof is very identical to the proof in the chain rule. So you can now apply the chain rule proof. You can easily prove the now these formulas. Are the channel capacity? Channel capacity is defined by the C, capital C. So this is the maximum value of the average mutual information is known as channel capacity, right? Now you can put all the formula here of the mutual information. Clear? So this is the channel capacity. Next formula is the rate of information. Rate of information denoted by capital R into H, where capital R is the rate of information, rate of flow of the information, H is the entropy of the information. Now from here you can see R is the message rate, small R is the message rate, H is the entropy. Other formula is the rate of transmission. Rate of transmission is Ct. Ct equals to, this is the C by T. C is the channel capacity, t second is known as rate of transmission. Now other important formula which are very effective to calculate the numerical value in the information theory and coding, known as the channel efficiency. Channel efficiency is denoted by eta. Eta equals to the actual transformation to the maximum transformation. Basically this is the average mutual information to the maximum value of the average mutual information. R, this is I x colon y divided by channel capacity. And next formula is basically the absolute redundancy. Absolute redundancy is defined by the channel capacity. Channel capacity means maximum value of the I x colon y minus I x colon y. This is equal to channel capacity minus I x colon y. This is the absolute redundancy, means how to calculate the extra information, unwanted information in the received signal or in the transmitted signal, known as the absolute redundancy. Redundancy means unwanted information or extra information or unimportant information, right? Now next one is the relative redundancy. relative redundancy is basically Ra upon C. Absolute redundancy upon the maximum value of the average mutual information. R, this is equal to Ra upon C. Absolute information about the general capacity, right? So these are the important relationship, important formula which are used to calculate the numerical value of these quantity, these parameter. In next lecture, I will discuss about the block diagram of the block diagram of the digital communication, means second block, the source encoder. Clear? The source encoder basically represents the source data at the lower bit rate and lower rate. Thank you.